Today, we will talk about the Canberra Class ship. The Canberra Class is an amphibious assault ship, precisely an LHD Landing Helicopter Dock. The largest ships ever built for the Royal Australian Navy. It provides the Australian Defence Force with one of the most capable and sophisticated air-land-sea amphibious deployment systems in the world. In 2000, the Australian Navy began planning to upgrade its amphibious fleet based on its experience leading the International Force for East Timor peacekeeping mission. In 2004, French company Direction de Construction's Navales, DCN, and Spanish company Navantia were invited to tender proposals, with DCN offering the Mistral-class amphibious assault ship, and Navantia proposing the Juan Carlos 1 design. The Spanish design was selected in 2007, with Navantia responsible for the construction of the ships from the keel to the flight deck, and BAE Systems Australia handling the fabrication of the combat and communications systems. The first LHD, HMAS Canberra, was commissioned on November 28, 2014, and the second ship, HMAS Adelaide, was commissioned on December 4, 2015. The ship is a conventional steel mono-hull design, with the superstructure located on the starboard side of the flight deck. There are four main decks, the well deck and heavy vehicle deck, main accommodation deck, hangar and light vehicle deck, and the flight deck. The 13-degree ski jump ramp of Juan Carlos 1 has been retained in Canberra-class ships, although is not intended for use. It has been designed with the shallowest possible draft to allow her to operate in secondary ports and harbors, as well as maneuver tactically in the shallow waters, common in the littoral regions. At full load, each ship will displace 27,500 tons, making them the largest vessels to serve in the RAN. The Canberras have the same physical dimensions as Juan Carlos 1, but differ in the design of the island superstructure and the internal layout, in order to meet Australian conditions and requirements. The ship's companies consist of 358 personnel, 293 from the Navy, 62 from Army, and 3 from Air Force. Each ship is fitted with a Saab 9LV Mark IV combat management system. The system performs threat evaluation, engagement planning, and weapon assignment missions. The sensor suite includes a Sea Giraffe 3D surveillance radar, helicopter control and surface radar, navigation radar, and a Vampir NG infrared search and track system. For self-defense, the LHDs are fitted with four Rafale Typhoon 25mm remote weapons systems, one in each corner of the flight deck, six 12.7mm machine guns, an SLQ-25 Nixie towed torpedo decoy, and Nulka active missile decoy system. Planned upgrades include the installation of up to three Phalanx close-in weapon systems. Defense against aircraft and larger targets is to be provided by escort vessels and air support from the Royal Australian Air Force. The main accommodation deck is located above the well dock and heavy vehicle deck, and includes crew accommodation, mess decks, medical spaces, galley facilities, office spaces, and recreation rooms. The LHDs are capable to transport 1,046 soldiers and their equipment, and can carry 1,600 in overload conditions. The well deck normally accommodates for LCM-1E amphibious landing craft. For additional rigid-hulled inflatable boats can be carried during emergency situations. The well deck is also capable of housing landing craft utilities, amphibious vehicles, and landing craft air cushions. Two vehicle decks, one for light vehicles, and the other for heavy vehicles and tanks, have areas of 1,880 square meters and 1,410 square meters respectively, and between them can accommodate up to 110 vehicles. The heavy vehicle deck may alternately be used for cargo, with a capacity of 196 shipping containers. The flight deck is 202.3 meter long and 32 meter wide. It allows the operation of rotary wing aircraft of the Australian Defence Forces, with six spots for helicopters up to MRH-90 size to operate simultaneously. Alternately, helicopters up to Chinook size can take off or land simultaneously on four spots on the flight deck. The standard air group aboard these ships will be a mix of MRH-90 transport helicopters and MH-60R anti-submarine helicopters. The 990 square meters hangar deck can accommodate 8 medium-size helicopters, and an additional 10 can be carried if the light vehicle deck is used for additional helicopter space. Propulsion is provided by two 11 megawatt, or 15,000 horsepower azimuth thrusters, each with an onboard electric motor, driving two 15-foot diameter propellers. The electricity is provided by a combined diesel and gas system, with a single General Electric LM2500 turbine producing 19,160 kilowatts, or 25,690 horsepower, supported by two Navantia MAN 16V32-40 diesel generators providing 7,448 kilowatts, or 9,988 horsepower. The vessels have a maximum speed of over 20 knots, or 37 kilometers per hour, and an economical cruising speed of 15 knots, or 28 kilometers per hour, with a range of 9,000 nautical miles, or 17,000 kilometers. The LHDs can maintain full directional control while reversing at up to 8 knots, or 15 kilometers per hour. That's it for today. See you in the next video.